Dear students, in the previous class we have studied about the specific and equivalent conductance, its determination, and we have also studied what is the effect of dilution on specific and equivalent conductance. We have also studied Kolb-Raz law and how to determine the equivalent conductance of a weak electrolyte. Today, the next topic we are going to study is conductometric titration. What is conductometric titrations? In a normal titration that we are doing in our laboratory, usually the end point of this reaction or the reaction completion is found out by color change of an indicator. Okay, we are taking one solution in the burette, another solution in the conical flask, adding few drops of indicator, we are titrating this. From the color change of the indicator, we are finding out the end point of the titration. From the end point, we are finding out the strength of a given unknown acids. But this titration is different from that normal titration. Here we are not using any indicator. Okay. Just we are measuring the conductance, and the measured conductance is plotted in a graph. From the graph, we are finding out the endpoint of this reaction. The first conductometric titration given in your syllabus is the titration between strong acid and strong base, that is hydrochloric acid versus sodium hydroxide. This is actually acid-base titration, that is neutralization titration. See, the reaction is when hydrochloric acid is titrated against the sodium hydroxide, sodium chloride salt is formed and water. Then how to carry out this reaction? Okay. How to carry out this reaction? First, what we are doing is we are taking sodium hydroxide in the burette and a given unknown acid, unknown hydrochloric acid, is taken in a beaker in which the cell is immersed. This is the cell. It is immersed in a solution. Okay. This is connected to the conductivity bridge where there is a digital display of conductance. Every time you are adding sodium hydroxide from the burette, okay, stirring the solution by means of a glass rod, and after every addition of sodium hydroxide, we are measuring the conductance of a solution. From the measured conductance, we are finding out the end point of the reaction. Now let us see how to find out. See, after every 1 cc of addition of sodium hydroxide, we are measuring the conductance. See, when the measured is plotted against the volume of sodium hydroxide, what happens? Initially, the conductance is maximum. Why? Because it has H plus ions The express ions are very smaller in size. They will move very fast. The conductance of any ion mainly depends on their mobility or its velocity. The conductance is initially measured is maximum. This is due to fast moving express ions of hydrochloric acid present in the beaker. When sodium hydroxide is added from the burette, what happens? The fast moving express ions are replaced by slow moving OH minus ions of sodium hydroxide. The express ions are taken up by OH minus ions of the base. So what happens? The number of express ions goes on decreases. So therefore, conductance decreases like this. Okay. When sodium hydroxide is going on added to hydrochloric acid, the conductance goes on decreases. This is due to replacement of fast moving H plus ions by slow moving OH plus ions. Therefore, the conductance decreases. When all the H plus ions are completely replaced or completely neutralized or completely replaced by OH plus ions, when no more H plus ions are there, after reaching the end point, the excess addition of sodium hydroxide will supply OH minus ions. That OH minus ions are having very high conductance, therefore conductance suddenly increases. This increase in the conductance is due to OH minus ions of sodium hydroxide. After the end point, the excess addition of sodium hydroxide will supply OH minus ions. That OH minus ions are having very high conductance, therefore conductance suddenly increases. When we join these points, we get a line like this, and we join these points. The intersection point of these two lines gives the end point of the spectrum. This actually shows the end point. This gives the end point of the spectrum. What it actually shows? This end point shows so much amount of sodium hydroxide required to neutralize a given unknown quantity of hydrochloric acid given. So, this actually shows the end point of the titration. This is the volume of sodium hydroxide required to neutralize a given quantity of hydrochloric acid. So, when the strong acid like hydrochloric acid is titrated against a strong base sodium hydroxide, we get this type of curve. Okay, the intersection point gives the end point of the titration. From the end point, we can easily calculate the amount of strong acid present in the given solution. So, this is about the conductometric titration between hydrochloric acid and sodium hydroxide. The next titration we are going to study now is, what happens when weak acid like acetic acid is titrated against sodium hydroxide? See, when weak acid is titrated against sodium hydroxide, the reaction is, it is also acid based reaction, that is neutralization titration. See, when acetic acid is titrated against sodium hydroxide, sodium acetate salt is formed and water. Here also, I am taking acetic acid in a beaker. And same sodium hydroxide taken in the cuvette. Now also, a conductivity cell is immersed in acetic acid. It is connected to the conductivity plate. From the digital display, we can find out the conductance at every time. Okay? A glass rod is introduced to stir the solution. Listen, now we start again the titration. Okay? I am taking a given quantity of acetic acid in a beaker. Sodium hydroxide is added. After every addition, that is after every 1 cc addition of sodium hydroxide to acetic acid, I am measuring the conductance. Again, when the measured conductance is plotted against the volume of sodium hydroxide, conductance unit ohm inverse is plotted against the volume of sodium hydroxide added from the burette. Okay? When I measure the conductance initially before starting the titration, the conductance is very minimum, low. This is the point. Why the conductance initially is very low? This is because a poor dissociative nature of acetic acid. Acetic acid is a weak acid. It is a weak electrolyte. It will undergo very slow dissociation to give H plus ions. Very few H plus ions will be there. So therefore the conductance is very low initially. When I start titration, when I am adding sodium hydroxide from the burette, what happens? Sodium acetate salt is formed. This sodium acetate is a strong electrolyte. Okay? It is a strong electrolyte which has very high conductance. So therefore, conductance slowly increases. Like this. As more and more sodium hydroxide is added to acetic acid, more and more amount of sodium acetate salt is formed. Therefore, conductance gradually increases. This increase in the conductance is due to the formation of sodium acetate salt, which is a strong electrolyte. Therefore, the conductance gradually increases. When all the acetic acid is completely neutralized, when all the acetic acid is completely converted into sodium acetate, that is when the end point is reached, when no more acetic acid is present in the beaker, the excess addition of sodium hydroxide after the end point will supply OH- ions which has very high conductance, therefore conductance suddenly increases. Like this. Conductance suddenly increases. This increase in the conductance is due to excess addition of sodium hydroxide added. The excess addition of sodium hydroxide added will supply OH- ions which has very high conductance, so therefore conductance suddenly increases. Now, when we join the lines, we get this type of cap. The intersection point of these two lines gives the end point of the titration. This is the end point. Okay? This end point actually shows so much amount of sodium hydroxide required to neutralize a given quantity of acetic acid. So therefore, the amount of sodium hydroxide or this end point actually corresponds to the volume of sodium hydroxide required to neutralize a given quantity of acetic acid taken in the beaker. So, when the weak acid is titrated against a strong base, we get a different shaped cap. So, acetic acid and the sodium hydroxide is titrated, we get this shaped cap. And when hydrochloric acid is titrated against the sodium hydroxide, we get V-shaped cap. So, this is the purpose of conductometry. detectors. That is reducing conductor. That is reducing conductance. We are finding out the endpoint of this detector. So we have studied two different types of conductometric, two different types of detectors. That is strong acid versus strong base, hydrochloric acid versus sodium hydroxide, and the second one is acetic acid versus sodium hydroxide. The next topic we will study in the next class.